the presence of the Lord, the Holy One is here. Come bow before him now with reverence and
Very good morning to you all on this service of the baptism of Christ. There's going to be a short meditation in this service, and because it's going to be recorded, you will be able to spend more quiet times because obviously I won't be able to give you very long during the meditation. But if you want to, you can keep stopping and starting your recorder. Let's take a moment of quiet as we prepare to worship God. As if this were the only time and this the only place and we the only people,
Jesus Christ will meet us.
As if this were the only time and this the only place and we the only people,
let us worship God.
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second commandment is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly
love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And the collect for today. Eternal Father, who at the baptism of Jesus revealed him to be your Son, anointing him with the Holy Spirit, grant to us who are born again by water and the Spirit, that we may be faithful to our calling as your adopted children, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen. May God guide each of us in the way of Christ, whatever our age or experience. May the love of God speak to us all. Our reading from the Old Testament is from Isaiah chapter 43. But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Saviour. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my sight and honoured, and I love you, I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring you your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away, and my daughters from the ends of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard set a feast for them.
my hand will say. Finest bread I will provide till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it
the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As the people were filled with expectation and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Now, when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, You are my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may like to close your eyes for this meditation of Jesus being baptized. Imagine yourself at a river, perhaps a river to which you've been before and that you find yourself enjoying and relaxing by. Imagine yourself on the bank of that river, and perhaps there are 30 or 40 people there. Take note of the sun and the way it warms your body and your face. Take note of the breeze, the gentle breeze that brushes your hair and caresses your face. Cool yourself down, find yourself standing knee-deep in the water, at a point where the water is not too rapid. Notice your feet in your sandals on the rocks. And feel the fresh coldness of the water. See the green trees and the song of the birds. immerse yourself with all the sights and sounds and feelings of this place, one of your favourite rivers. See yourself in a line of people now. One by one, they go into the water, waist deep. There is a man there waiting for each person. He is John the Baptist. He's the one who is helping to baptize people, people who truly want to follow God. See yourself in the queue standing beside a person named Jesus. Maybe you have never met him, or maybe you have in the past. Notice what he's wearing. Notice his body language. Notice how he carries himself and relates to people. Notice the way he looks at people and the way he relates to you. One by one, the people continue to be baptized by John the Baptist, submerged in the water and coming out. And now you see that it's Jesus' turn. You see that John speaks to him, shaking his head and his hands as if to say no. But then you see John holding Jesus and gently pushing him under the water for a few seconds. You see him coming out of the water, water dripping from his hair and face. Then something strange seems to be happening. Though Jesus is a few feet away from you, you are able to hear what he hears. A voice calling Jesus' name with so much intimacy and tenderness that can only come from God's call. You hear the voice calling Jesus by name and saying, "You are my beloved Son. On you my favour rests." Watch Jesus. See how he receives that voice. See how he responds to God's, Abba's, voice. Now it is your turn. You approach John the Baptist and he asks if you are ready. And he submerges you into the water. Feel the water on your hair and face. What are you thinking? For a brief second, it seems like a certain dying. You rise from the water, dripping wet. And like Jesus, you hear a voice calling you by name. Perhaps the name your parents gave you. Perhaps a nickname. Or maybe a name you have not known before. A name he wants to call you. With so much love and tenderness and intimacy, which only God can speak to your heart, you hear God calling your name and saying, "You are my precious child. On you, my favor rests." Then see Jesus, who is about 10 feet away from you. He has turned to look at you. He gazes straight into your eyes. The kind of look that penetrates your soul, but without being threatening. He looks at you with love and with all-knowing compassion. Then Jesus calls you by name, the same way as the voice from heaven did. With tenderness and love, he says to you, "You are so important to me, and I love you." How do you respond to his voice? Notice how you embrace his words. Or maybe you hesitate or push away. Whatever is in your mind and heart, express that to Jesus. Have an intimate conversation. See his glance or smile. And share with Jesus what you feel and what is going on in your heart. Now listen to Jesus. Allow Jesus to share with you what is going on in his heart now that you have spoken to him. Let Jesus enjoy his time with you. Let him embrace you, or cry with you, or laugh with you. Whatever he wants to do. Rest in him who wants to rest in you. Spend as much time as you like to be with him, because he loves to be with you. Before you finish, take time to thank Jesus for your time with him. Amen. As we are all united in baptism, we ask you to help us to break down the barriers that keep us apart. As all things are made new in your Son, renew your church, we pray, that we may gather new strength for the mission that you have charged us with, of spreading the good news. Lord, as you have called us, make us worthy of our calling. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, as your Holy Spirit moved upon the face of the waters, you brought light into the world. Look now, we pray, on the hidden corners of our world and lighten the darkness of ignorance and error, that the world may be truly free. Breathe something of your wisdom and compassion into the souls of those who have the authority over others. that they may exercise it wisely. And we particularly pray today for the people of Yemen. Lord, as you have called us, make us worthy of our calling. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Pour forth, O Lord, your love upon this land and its people, as we try to follow the example of your Son, in whom you were well pleased. Daily renew in us the desire to serve you and our neighbour, and help us to overcome all pettiness in our dealings with each other. Lord, as you have called us, make us worthy of our calling. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, look with pity, we pray, on those whose lives are bruised, whose hopes are quenched. Help them to feel the reality of your wonderful promise that you will be a constant presence to us through fire and flood, and that we shall not be overwhelmed, since you are always with us, even to the end of the world. Lord, as you have called us, make us worthy of our calling. In your mercy, hear our prayer. We commend to your love those who, washed in the waters of baptism, were close to you in this life and are now one with you in eternal life. May they rest in your love and the life of your Spirit. Lord, as you have called us, make us worthy of our calling. In your mercy, hear our prayer. And we offer peace to one another. Christ is our peace. If anyone is in Christ, they are a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, everything has become new. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And we bow our heads for our blessing. In gratitude, in deep gratitude for this moment and one another, we give ourselves to you. Take us out to live as changed people, because meeting with you, we cannot remain the same. Ask much of us. Expect much from us, enable much by us, encourage many through us. So, Lord, may we live to your glory, both as inhabitants of the earth and citizens of the commonwealth of heaven. Amen. May God, the Father, who led the wise men by the shining of a star to find the Christ, the light from light, lead you also in your pilgrimage to find the Lord. Amen. May God, the Son, who turned water into wine at the wedding feast at Cana, transform your lives and make glad your hearts. Amen. May God, the Holy Spirit, who came upon the beloved Son at his baptism in the River Jordan, pour out his gifts on you who have come to the waters of new birth. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest upon you, your homes, and all whom you love, now and forever. Amen.
Shelter of the Lord, who abideth. in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun.